History addicts, welcome back to History Supply. What do you get when you combine bananas, communism, and exploitation? You get invaded by the United States of America.
The United Fruit Company, also known as the Octopus, had a monopoly on the banana trade. It was the classic symbol of neocolonialism and exploitation. By 1930, it was already the largest employer in Central America, owning 3.5 million acres in Central America, and was the largest landowner in Guatemala.
I'm Chiquita Banana, and I've come to say bananas have to ripen in a certain way, and when they're flecked with brown and have a golden hue, bananas taste the best and are the best for you. You can put them in a salad.
Grief?
No, not yet, my dear. That greenish way you're looking means that you are ripe for cooking.
How about me?
In 1952, Guatemalans overthrew their military dictator, and for the first time ever, there were free and fair elections. The democratically elected Jacob Arbenz began taking over some of the United Fruit Company's land and handing it over to landless peasants. The United Fruit Company had strong ties to the American government and began an intense lobbying campaign. In the Cold War atmosphere of the time, it was easy to portray Jacob Arbenz as a communist instead of just a democratically elected prime minister who was trying to take his country back from the clutches of the United Fruit Company. The American government became convinced that Guatemala was going to take over the entire United Fruit Company, and that would encourage other takeovers of other American companies. The total value of these companies was $5 billion, and they included strategic interests in mining and oil. In August 1963, the CIA carried out Operation PB Success. This was an intensive paramilitary and psychological campaign to replace the popular elected government with a far-right military dictator. This triggered a civil war in Guatemala that lasted for 30 years. The military dictatorship further created a genocide of the Mayan people, which the USA was aware of. Then, to cover things up in the face of widespread international condemnation, the US government launched Operation PB History to find evidence of Soviet involvement. Of course, they couldn't really find any.
History addicts, the 1984 Guatemalan coup d'etat. Please like and subscribe. It means a lot to me personally, and it allows me to keep making videos like these. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you next time.